Welcome to the Gentlemen's Scholars Club and another edition of What Am I Wearing Today and Why? It's winter, it's mid-February, temperature around freezing, cloudy weather. Decided to wear a turtleneck today, merino wool from the French made-to-measure boutique Jean-Manuel Moreau, located in Paris. And as a suit, I have dark brown flannel from Rose and Born in Sweden. It has flat pockets and a ticket pocket as well on it. It's a bit more fitted than I usually would wear, and also a bit shorter than I would like. It's something I purchased a few years ago. I think it might be their Parma model, I'm not sure, because it has been a few years, but I decided to break it out today to wear with this mid blue. Lastly, I have a pocket square and a wool from Proper Cloth, American company, most known for its made-to-measure shirting. Also now doing made-to-measure trousers and tailoring, as well as for their accessories. They have some interesting accessories. Why am I wearing this today? Decided to wear a mid-blue rather than a darker blue, because I think mid-blue pops nicely against darker colors that you're wearing. So if you're going to wear a charcoal, if you're wearing a dark gray tailoring, try something that's mid-tone if you're wearing a turtleneck or knitwear, rather than something darker. If you wear a dark color like navy, or another a dark brown, you'll create more of a muddled or muddy sort of dark look to yourself. And it's great to have this kind of pop of color, especially if it's cloudy out. It's substituting for the blue skies that we were hoping for. Navy or darker colors also tend to wash you out more if you have a pale complexion. And in the winter, you'll be even more pallid because you don't have the opportunity to tan. So if you wear a darker color, that contrast will really make you look even paler. So mid-tones or lighter tones are ideal in shirting or knitwear, especially a turtleneck, which really tends to highlight your face area. Wore this pocket square in a wool, so similar fabric, same fabric essentially, and similar tone. So this pocket square brings the brightness of the knitwear out onto the swath of material here that is the jacket. If you don't have this and you saw this, if I didn't wear this and you saw this in person, it would look kind of plain and dark and sober without the pocket square. So adding this pop of color here brightens up the outside of the outfit, carries the brightness of the knitwear to the outside as well. And a question that also arises when wearing dark brown trousers, and this is part of a suit, would be what type of shoes do you wear? What color shoes do you wear? Usually with brown, you'd want to wear brown, but you don't really want to go much lighter than the trousers. Usually you want to go darker with your shoes than your pants or trousers. So I would recommend as an ideal something that's dark brown, and you could even go toward black with this. Give it a try though. Try something in black, try something in a dark brown if you're wearing brown trousers, and see which one looks better. You really don't want to go lighter than your trousers though if you choose brown as the option. Since this is a smart casual outfit and it's kind of woolly or rugged because of the turtleneck and because of the textures, I would recommend even wearing boots, dress boots in particular, again in the same color choices, either black or a darker brown. If you get darker brown, if you get a mid brown shoe or boot, and you know you'll be wearing brown trousers a lot, you can have the polish redone to make it darker. You can either do it yourself or have a professional darken the patina on your shoes so that you can wear it with dark brown trousers. Hope that's useful as some style advice for the winter months. If you found it so, subscribe to the Gentlemen Scholars Club to receive more tips and advice on classic men's style. Thanks for watching.